When working on your videos for your channel, business, or your clients, you can use callouts and text callouts to enhance your videos. You can choose whatever colors you want for those callouts. However, you've probably worked very hard to design your logo and website with specific colors to represent your business. The question becomes how to have access to those specific colors for the video you are currently working on and for future videos. I'm Naomi Skarzinski with the Top Shelf VA channel, your place for creativity and inspiration for business and life. If you haven't already done so, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. So the question was, how do you create a permanent color palette you can easily have access to from video to video to video? There are two ways to do this, both easy, one faster, the second a little slower. You will need to download this utility, which is extremely fast to do and takes practically no space on your hard drive. The link is below in the description. Go to nattyware.com, click on Pixie, click on In a Zipped Archive, save the file on your hard drive where you normally save your download files. I already have this on my hard drive, so I'll just say yes when it asks me if I want to replace it. Go back to where you saved the file, extract the zipped file, hover over the Pixie application and double-click and say run. It's that quick. Let's close out of everything for a moment. Simply click on your start icon and all programs. Scroll down to Nattyware and click on it. Right-click on Run Pixie and select either Pin to Taskbar or Pin to Start menu. Now open your website. I'll use mine at topshelfva.com and open Run Pixie from the Start menu or the Taskbar wherever you decided to place it. The utility will pop up in the center of the monitor, and wherever I place my cursor, it will give the color of the pixel at the point where my cursor is currently placed. Have pen and paper ready to write down these numbers. Let's go ahead and start with the logo in the dark teal, which is RGB 0141179. Let's move to the light blue, which is RGB 124189206. The green RGB is 155204080. I also like to use this purple, which is RGB 10784148. Now that I have all my colors I want for my palette, I can close out of Pixie and go back to Camtasia to set up the permanent colors. Let's go ahead and place a simple rectangle callout box, click on Fill, then More Fill Colors, and what we are going to do is use these blank areas to set up the palette. Now this is important. To set the colors, you must follow this order. Click on the first blank rectangle and you will see a light dotted outline. Then in the red, green, blue area, your RGB, you enter the colors you wrote down. For the teal, you type in 0141179 and then click on Add to Custom Colors. Click on the next blank rectangle, move over to the RGB and type in the numbers for light blue. 124189206 and click on Add to Custom Colors. Then click on the next blank rectangle, move over to the RGB and type in the numbers for green, 155204080, and click on Add to Custom Colors. Click on the next blank rectangle, move over to the RGB and type in the numbers for purple, 10784148, and click on Add to Custom Colors. Now you have your custom palette. No matter what callout you choose, you have access to the colors you want to use most often. If you want to change the color, just click on a different one of your branding colors and say OK. You can also do this with your text callouts. Let's say you wanted to change the black text to one of your colors. Select all the text in the box here, then click on the drop-down for the text colors. Choose More Text Colors, and you can choose the branding color you want, and it's as simple as that. You might be saying, what if I close out of Camtasia? Do I have to set up the colors all over again? Let's go ahead and test that and close out of Camtasia. Let's open Camtasia again and add a call out. We're going to click on fill, then more fill colors, and oh my gosh, there's your branding color palette. They will always be there unless you change it, and you will always have access to it from one video to the next video. Now let me show you the second easy way of saving your colors to your palette. I'm just going to show you a couple steps since it does take a little bit longer. If you do not already have the image file for your masthead, take a screenshot of your masthead and save it to your hard drive. Then import the image to your clip bin from wherever you saved it on your hard drive and add it to your timeline. Expand it so you can see all the colors. Add a call out. Once again, this has to be done in this order, otherwise it won't work properly. Click on drop down for the fill and then click on select color, which gives you a little eyedropper cursor. Move the cursor over the color you want to select and click on the color you want, which fills in the callout. Then go back to the fill drop down menu, more fill colors, and write down the RGB colors of what the eyedropper had selected. Click on the first blank rectangle and you will see it switches the color to white. Go back to the RGB and type in the numbers you just wrote down, then click on Add to Custom Colors and click on OK. Then to get the next color, you do the same process over again until all of your colors have been selected that you want. As you can see, although easy, there are several more steps involved. This is why I like the first step using the Pixie utility to gather all my colors first and adding them to the custom color palette all at once without having to go in and out of the Camtasia color palette so many times. There you have it, how to set up a custom palette of your branding colors. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and leave a comment. If you haven't already done so, don't forget to subscribe so you will be notified every time I upload a new video. Thank you so much for watching. As always, this is Naomi with TopShelfVA.com. Until we meet again, have a wonderful day.